Big news, Microsoft has just announced something really interesting. If you're still on Windows 10, the company will make the Extended Security Update program free, but there is a big catch. You can read my full take on this topic using the link in the description. Okay, big news from Microsoft. As it turns out, you will be able to continue to use Windows 10 for another year. In the latest announcement, the company has confirmed a few options to continue to get updates after October 14, 2025, which, as you know, is the end of support for Windows 10. So as part of this new approach, Microsoft will offer you two options for free and one paid. So the first one is to backup your data and settings to the cloud using the Windows Backup tool. The other option is to use your Microsoft Rewards points to complete the enrollment, or you can just pay the full price for an extra year or updates. Okay, so let's look at these options in more detail. So once the program is ready for your computer, you will notice a notification on the Windows Update page, and then when you click that option, you will get this wizard that allows you to choose how you want to enroll your computer. For example, if you choose to sync your settings and files to OneDrive using the Windows Backup option, then the Extended Security Update program will be free. If you are already a Microsoft 365 personal or family subscriber, then this is perhaps the best option since you're also probably already backing up your data to the cloud. On the other hand, if you don't have a subscription, you will quickly realize that 5 GB of free space might not be enough. And here's where the program pays off for Microsoft, as the company hopes that making the extended support free, it will help to bring more customers to the Microsoft 365 product. Now, if you don't have a subscription, you can simply choose this option, but at the time of backing up your data, just choose a folder that doesn't have too many files. Now, if you were already thinking on getting a subscription, then perhaps that will be the best time to do it. For the second option, if you are enrolled in the Microsoft Rewards program and you have at least 1,000 points, you can redeem those points to enroll your computer into the Extended Security Update program for free, while you actually be spending 1,000 points. The Rewards program is also an option, and it might be better than using the Windows Backup option if you don't have a subscription. You only need to sign in to the Rewards program using your Microsoft account. Once in the program, you can complete different quests to earn different amount of points, and once you reach 1,000, you can redeem them to access the extended support for Windows 10. One thing to point out is that if you scan this code, at least at the time of this video, and you download the Bing app, you will earn 500 points right there. And lastly, if you want to continue having updates and use Windows 10, you can pay for the extended support, and that will cost you $30, but the price might vary depending on where you're located. Of course, if your computer meets the minimum requirements, the best approach is to upgrade to Windows 11. After the enrollment, you will continue to receive security updates, and your computer will continue to be supported from October 15, 2025 through October 13, 2026. Now, when will you be able to enroll into the extended update program? Well, starting on June 24, 2025, Microsoft is making the extended security updates enrollment available for Windows 10 for devices in the Windows Insider program. Now, in July 2025, the company will begin expanding the enrollment to consumers outside of the Windows Insider program. Finally, in mid-August, everyone will have the option to enroll for free to the Extended Security Updates program. So what does this program include? Well, the Extended Security Update program offers critical and important updates for Windows 10 during the transition period. This offering does not provide new features, design changes, or any other type of updates. Also, this isn't meant to be a solution to keep using the operating system. It is meant to help you to plan a transition to a new system as soon as possible. Finally, this program does not offer any technical support from the company. So how long your computer will receive updates? Well, the extended update program is only available for one extra year after the end of support of Windows 10. So after you enroll your computer in the program, Windows 10 will continue to be supported and it will receive security updates for 1 year from October 15, 2025 through October 13, 2026. And finally, should you use the extended update program for Windows 10? Well, in my opinion, the short answer is no. You shouldn't use this program. Instead, you should upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11 before the support ends. If your computer meets the minimum requirements, you can upgrade directly from the Windows update settings. In the case that you have the same installation for a long time, it is possible to upgrade doing a clean installation of Windows 11. Another option is to install Windows 11 on unsupported hardware. Check the video description because I have links to all the different tutorials on how to upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11. Or you can switch operating systems. For example, you can use Linux Mint or Chrome OS Flex. Even though these operating systems might not be for everyone, always remember to create a full backup of your current setup before proceeding with any upgrade path. And that's it. Are you planning to enroll your computer and extend the update program? Let me know in the comments. Also, like the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that yet, and I just hope this video was informative for you, and I would like to thank you for viewing.